Praise the Lord, everybody. Praise the Lord, everybody. Did anybody come to bless the Lord on tonight? Why don't you stand to your feet and let's give God a praise in this place. Hallelujah, Jesus. We bless your holy name, God. We come to give you glory. We come to give you honor. We come to give you praise tonight. For you are the only true and living God. And we come to celebrate you tonight. We come to give you our best praise. Come on, hallelujah, Jesus. Come on. We come to give him glory tonight. For he is an awesome God.
God is an awesome God.
Yes, he is. great and awesome, powerful, mighty God. Somebody lift him up in this place.
Oh, why don't we give him another hand clap of praise tonight? He's worthy. Praise God. We're going to go into a season of prayer. So often when we come up here, we quote from James chapter 5. It says, in the prayer of faith, is any sick among you? Let him call for the elders of the church and let them pray over him, anointing him with oil in the name of the Lord. And the prayer of faith shall save the sick, and the Lord shall raise him up. And if he have committed any sin, they shall be forgiven him. As I was praying, this verse came to mind. Verse 16 says, confess your faults one to another and pray one for another that ye may be healed. The effectual, fervent prayer of a righteous man availeth much. And so it might be a little bit different tonight, but I want to invite you to come to this altar, not just by yourself, but get a friend. If you know somebody that has a need, why don't you grab them by the arm? And why don't you come up here and pray with your brother and pray with your sister that you may be healed. Amen. We're in this together, church. Until the Lord comes back, until he calls up his church, we're in this together. Amen. And I don't know about you, but if I have sickness in my body, I'm thankful to know that there are people that are praying for me. And if you have sickness in your body, it's reassuring to know that your brothers and your sisters have your back and that they're praying for you and that they're lifting you up before the name of the Lord and asking God to work on your behalf. Amen. As the elders come, we invite you, get somebody with you. Pray with your brother. If you see somebody that's by themselves, put your hand on their shoulder and ask God to work on their behalf today. Jesus, we thank you, God. Lord, lay your hand upon those that are sick, Lord, those that are fighting the sickness right now. We're asking that your healing virtue would be upon their bodies and that you would help them and that you would heal them. Lord, I'm asking that you see every need, every situation in this house. You're a prayer answering God. You're a faithful God, and there's nothing that's too big for you. We believe you for it right now. We believe you for miracles, signs, and wonders in our midst. We believe you for healing right now, God. We claim it in Jesus' name. Oh, hallelujah. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Oh, you're wonderful. House. God wants to do something great and mighty in this house. If we'll just allow him to have his way. Oh, can we just begin to thank him? Can we just begin to praise him all over this house?
Anything can happen. Anything. Anything can happen.
Jesus steps in the room, your miracle can happen. Your miracle can happen. Your miracle can happen. The moment that he wants it, anything can happen. Anything can happen. Anything can happen. The moment that you walk in, somebody give him glory. Somebody lift up the name of Jesus. Somebody give him the glory right now. Because anything can happen when he steps in the room. When you open your mouth and praise him and worship him and get in the Holy Ghost, he'll step in. He'll step in. Anybody need a healing in this place? I dare you to call on the name of Jesus. I dare you to stretch forth your hand. In the name of Jesus, we declare your power, God. We declare your healing, God. We declare your healing virtue to flow in this place, God.
Thank him for the moving of the Spirit that's in this house already. Come on, let's thank him. Let him hear you say thank you. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you so much, God, for being in this house right now. Oh, thank you, Jesus. We worship you. We praise you. a sweet, sweet presence of God is here. And let us not take it for granted that Jesus stopped by tonight. Thank you, Jesus. Amen. Please remember, there's just a couple of announcements. Please remember that tomorrow evening will be family prayer. At 6:30 p.m. there will be discipleship class, the pastor's course following that. Any and all of you are welcome to join us for family prayer at 6:30 p.m. right here in the sanctuary. Also, Word in Action this Tuesday night at 7 p.m. And then youth service this Friday evening at 7 p.m. You do not want to miss that. Also, there will be a Heroes game night this Saturday from 6 to 8 p.m. Any and all are invited to come and be a part of that. And then Women in Action. Women in Action will be having an event February 10th. It will be a menu / meal swap that will be going on. That will follow the women's prayer. So there'll be women's prayer at 8 a.m. here in the sanctuary. Then it will convene to the Donna Cordova Center for that event. You can see Sister Tina Salas or Sister Cherry Fowler if you would like to be a part of that or you need more information on that. And then last but not least, Sister Tina and her team are going to be kicking off another financial class February 8th. February 8th. So if you would like to be a part of that financial class that is going on, please see Sister Tina and sign up to be a part of that. And then if you are a guest or a visitor in the house tonight, thank you so much for taking time out of your schedule. On this Sunday night, you could be doing a lot, and you're here worshiping with us. You made it to Sunday Night Live. Thank you so much for coming here tonight. We give you honor for that. Thank you. Hey, man, for just a few minutes, why don't you step out in the aisle? Why don't you get a big smile on your face? Find somebody you don't know, someone you haven't talked to yet. Let's greet each other and welcome each other to the house of the Lord tonight.
clap our hands and lift up our voices and worship Him. He's a good God, amen. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Wonderful Savior. Praise God. Amen. It is Mission Sunday, and you can stay standing as you're getting your tithe and offering. I won't be very long this evening, but I did want to just bring before the church that on March 3rd, a team of people from Christian Growth Center will be headed to the Philippines and to Vietnam, first to the Pacific Rim Summit. We'll actually this year have some leaders and some pastors from Vietnam joining us in the Philippines for the Pacific Rim Summit. It's exciting, amen, to build those connections between brothers and sisters of the apostolic faith, amen. But please pray that God's will be done while we're on that trip. And last year, God opened some very exciting doors, some amazing things happened, and I've just been praying and asking God. You know, we saw a lot of shifting and moving, but I would love to just see a lot of people filled with the Holy Ghost this year on this trip. Amen. Praise God. So please keep that in mind. And if you're joining us online this evening and you would like to support that endeavor, you can go to cgcpueblo.org and you can give from there. Just mark it missions. Put a memo on it for Vietnam. Amen. And let's invest in the harvest. Amen. How many believe that God wants to pour out the Holy Ghost in 2024? Amen. I want to be a part of it. Praise God. Let's read together. Enlarge the place of thy tent, and let them stretch forth the curtains of thine habitations. Spare not, lengthen thy cords, and strengthen thy stakes. For thou shalt break forth on the right hand and on the left, and thy seed shall inherit the Gentiles, and make the desolate cities to be inhabited. Amen. Let's bring it cheerfully this evening. For others, he'll do for you.
is moving on you, you ought to just talk in tongues for a little bit right now. You ought to let the Holy Ghost pray for you right now. Yeah, yeah! Hallelujah. Somebody ought to just praise him again. Somebody ought to just praise him again. You know, some people, they think this is just nonsense. The Bible says to the wise, according to the world standards, this is foolishness. But to them which believe, the same which the builders rejected, the same is made the head of the corner. We don't use a cornerstone anymore because we have all kinds of lasers and stuff. And when we set up forms to build foundations, they don't use that anymore. But in the old days, they use that cornerstone. And if that thing was set square, if that thing was set plumb, that building would be perfect. And the Bible says that Jesus Christ has made the chief cornerstone. And then our worship and our praise and our experience with God is part of that cornerstone. The Bible says that he inhabits the praise of his people. So in the logical mind, you think, well, we just need to move on with the service. No. Well, sometimes you do, but sometimes it's like this. This is moving on with the service.
Yes, yes, yes.
This is moving on with, this is where God is. This is where God's doing miracles, signs, and wonders.
God does during these times, but he moves. I'll never forget my grandmother telling me. My grandmother told me things that God did over there that I rarely speak about because people over here won't believe me. But when she was in Liberia, Africa, they were fighting witch doctors. Witch doctors had come against them, and they were casting spells and stuff on them. You say, well, that's nonsense. No, they do that stuff right here in Pueblo every day. Yeah. I see it. I see it, brothers and sisters. They just have patinas of what they call, you know, civilization. And so they made up their mind. She had prayed one of the main witch doctors through to the Holy Ghost. They baptized him in Jesus' name, and they said, we're gonna cast a spell on him and kill him. And the church was afraid because the church over there has seen a lot of the movings of evil spirits. And we're not afraid of them. We don't see stuff like that. It happens here in America, but we don't see it because it's covered up. It's not out in front of everybody. I'm talking about what these kind of services do. So they cast a spell. I can't remember if it was a leopard or a lion. literally, they watched this lion climb into the house of this witch doctor. And right as he was getting into the window, that church erupted in praise and worship to God.
Yeah. Yeah. Yes, 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 yes.
And when that church erupted in praise and worship to God, that cat fell in a heap at that window, dead. Nobody was around except people that were watching what was going on. When the church began to praise God, not only that, the witch doctor that cast the spell fell over dead at the same time. And the fear of God broke out in that place, and they started receiving the Holy Ghost. See, you don't know what God's doing in here right now. But I'm telling you, miracles, signs and wonders all over my life. You ought to pat yourself and say, all over my life.
Thank you.
And say miracles, signs, wonders all over their life. The Holy Ghost. Come on, let it pray for you. Let it pray for you. The Bible says, let the tongues of the Spirit of God pray for your life. That's it. We know not what to pray. Moving in this house right now. I'm telling you. telling you, he's moving in this house right now. Thank you, Jesus. 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 Hallelujah, 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 hallelujah. Woo! Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah.
believe in your power. You're a God of miracles, signs and wonders. We believe in your power. Listen, my children. Your faith and your sacrifice has not gone unnoticed. I will do things in the near future that it, when you see it, it's going to be beyond your ability to process it. When you see it, just keep believing me. When you see it, just keep praising. When you see it, just keep sacrificing. When you see it, just keep on being faithful to me. My coming is so soon, and I am doing works against the enemies of your soul. And I need you to give me the praise and the glory, because I am a great God and I am going to show myself mighty. Believe me, I am your God and I will not fail you. Come on, let's praise him. Let's praise him. Thank you, Jesus. Some of us are not finished praising, so can you just give us a few more minutes?
while we show God our appreciation, while we put a down payment of praise on His word. Just fixing to speak what God had put in my heart when He confirmed it with tongues and interpretation. When Paul went to Greece, he tried to go head to head with them, intellect for intellect. But when he went to Corinth, he said, when I come to you, it was not with enticing words and man's wisdom. But he said, I came in demonstration. Power of the Holy Ghost. We have been faithful, Christian Growth Center. Now it's time for us to pray. Pray like we've never prayed. God is stretching us this year. He's stretching some of us to pray like we've never prayed. Will we accept the challenge? Will we receive the challenge? I know there's many of you that have been so faithful to God, and you are, but God's reaching for other people in this church. If this church has one body, would turn into an intercession body. Can you imagine what God wants to do and will do? Right here in Pueblo, in the surrounding areas, in Greeley, in Vietnam, in Africa, we start a Bible study this week, I believe, in Africa. Maybe looking at going there in May. God only knows what God's going to do there. Brothers and sisters, we need miracles. It's beyond our ability to handle all of this stuff. We can't do it. But He can do it. How many of you are believing God with us? Mighty, mighty. I'm telling you, we need to get out of our denominationalism. Some of us are not used to the way that we pray and worship around here because the denominations that we come out of or lack of, they didn't do it this way. But you know as well as I do that the church world in America and Western Europe is as dead as doornails and have been for years, over 100 years. And the way that they're doing church, I'm not criticizing, I'm just stating a fact, okay? The way they're doing church ain't getting the job done. So God needs some people that will turn loose. And when you feel like praying in tongues, you pray in tongues. Don't hold it back. You got to get, yeah, I'm going to tell you something. There ain't no shame in my game, brothers and sisters. The shame went out the window a long time ago. We are not ashamed of the gospel of Jesus Christ, the Apostle Paul said. For it is the power of God and the salvation to those who believe. Praise God. And when we feel God moving on us to pray for people, no, we can't heal them. But I tell you what we can do. We can pray in faith. And God will heal them. And God will set them free. And God will deliver them. Praise God. Let's stand and let's thank God for the wonderful way that He has moved in this house tonight. Hallelujah. Let's thank Him for the way that He's moved in this place tonight. Hallelujah, 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 hallelujah. Woo! Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. I feel impressed in the Holy Ghost to say this, and this morning I knew who I was talking to, but tonight I don't. But I want you to listen, because the Holy Ghost is telling someone, listen to me. Listen to me. Not your family. Not your friends. Sometimes it's important to listen to people like that. I'm not knocking that. But God wants to talk directly to somebody tonight. And when He does, do what He tells you. Do what He tells you. Let the chips fall where they lie. So, Brother Elder, all hell's breaking. No, all hell's been breaking loose for 100 years. That's just the devil trying to put you into crisis mode. No, when God's speaking in your heart, all hell isn't breaking loose. All heaven is breaking loose. And you just do what He tells you to do. Let's clap our hands and thank Him for that word right now. Hallelujah. Praise God. Praise God. We need some people that will fast tomorrow. Who will fast tomorrow? Thank you. Need some people that will fast Tuesday. Thank you. Who will fast Wednesday? Thank you. Who will fast Thursday? Thank you. Who will fast Friday? Thank you. Who will fast Saturday? I see one. Give me one more. One more Saturday. Thank you. This kind goeth not out but by prayer and by fasting. We ought to say that with vigor. This kind goeth not out but by and fasting. Tomorrow night at 6:30 right here is our family prayer night. Come and pray with us. It is our vision and our goal that our Monday night prayer service is the largest attended service. We haven't got there yet, but we're going to get there. In Jesus' name, come pray with us at 6:30. Discipleship at 7 o'clock. 7 o'clock or 7:30 is 7 o'clock is pastor's course. And God bless you. Love one another. You are dismissed. Please greet all of our guests. We're so glad they're with us tonight. Brother James and Sister Chetty need to see all cadets immediately, right now. Immediamente. I can't hear. My left ear's jacked up. Anyway, I tried. Right over here. Pronto. Hallelujah.